Whatever happened to Rise of Liberty? Well, luckily for all of us, myself included, because I get to play it, they added a giant siege battle mode to this game a while ago, and I completely missed it. And you know, I love my siege battles, especially where we are going to be able to upgrade the defenses, call in different emplacements like cannons, or like the old Revolutionary War equivalent of like a machine gun. It's not quite that, but I'll show you it. But I was wondering, whatever happened to Rise of Liberty? Whatever happened to Jack? Jack, the developer of this game. Well, I randomly found him on TikTok a while ago, and he was making some cool videos. And yes, I have a TikTok too, and the link is in the video description where I try to make some cool videos. But I was just wondering whatever happened, and Jack has gone on and is working on some more games, including Stowaway, which is the Among Us like pirate game that I put up on the channel most recently. But I see Jack as just a source of inspiration. And all that being said, whatever happened to Rise of Liberty? Well, it got updated. And let's make the max number of infantry 300. And look at this. They added siege mode. I've played custom battle. I've played historical battles, but I've never played siege mode. So we have one called choke point, and we've one called siege mode. I'm going to check out siege mode. And if you guys do want to see more, let me know by pulling the trigger on the like button. And I will go ahead and make another video on choke point. So let's see exactly what's happening. It looks like the colonists, the rebel scum, some would say, but you know what? Just because we don't like tea doesn't mean we's rebel scum. They're holding this hilltop fortress, and there's different waves, right? So you have to hold on as many waves as possible. Look at these defenses. So you've got a mix of stone and wood, and all of these guys up here, including these lancers. I don't know why you'd want to be a lancer in a line battle, but we've got redcoats surrounding it. Yeah, it's been quite a while since we played Rise of Liberty, so if you're new to it, check out the game on Steam, man. The developer is... he made this game himself. It's glorious. It's beautiful. It's fun. Okay, now let's try to take command of, oh, this guy, maybe. Hello, friend. I will be you, and then you will be me, or rather, I'll be both of us. Gentlemen, we must hold the defenses. There's only 53 of those British tea drinkers left, and I'm sure many of you drink tea right now, but don't worry. Stick with me, and I'll introduce you to the liquid addiction known as coffee. Hello! You dirty, dirty Brit. Let's reload our flintlock musket here. I gotta find out how I upgrade my defenses. Gentlemen, please stop fighting. It really is most gentlemen. Ow! Someone shot me! And you can see in the bottom right, we've got some like squad controls. I think after we... oh, there's the guy with the flag. If you kill the guy with the flag for whatever reason... oh, look at this. See, that's what it's called, a puckle gun. I can buy infantry for $5. I can buy a mortar, a cannon, or a swivel gun. I'm gonna buy a swivel gun, and I'm gonna buy a bunch of infantry. Oh my God, 70 infantry? That's a lot. And I'm gonna get a mortar. So I need 24, but the stuff that I'd really want, which is like the Ferguson rifle, I'm gonna need 249 kills. Okay, guys, we need to win. And honestly, I think we will. There's 18 of them left. So let's go ahead and just pump that guy. But yeah, so this is like, it's essentially a Revolutionary War line battle simulator. And with the siege mode, well, it's a fortress defense one. And is this the pickle gun? Who is responsible for putting it here? That's the one thing I'd be curious about, is to see if I couldn't put it in a different spot. Hold on. Aha, that's why. I figured out what we did wrong. Okay. So then I'm gonna go up here, and then I'm gonna put in... oh God, oh, that's wave two, and look at how many redcoats are coming. The British are coming, the British are coming! Get a puckle gun here. Ha-ha! You guys ready to get puckled? You guys wanna get puckled, huh? Doesn't that sound a little weird if I'm the angry colonist in the tower yelling at you? Hey! Hey, you! You just wanna get puckled? Do ya? And then everyone's like, I actually don't really want to fight anymore. That man is quite intent on puckling me. And I don't think that would be rather becoming of a gentleman. So that is how we build defenses. Look at this thing, man. This thing is a puckler. I am gonna puckle. Okay, so there's 53 left. I still have 148. And there is a little bit of a timer, I think. So we need to, what, eliminate them? I wish I could get rid of that. All right, so if they're holding these, let's see. I'm gonna try to huckle up this tower over here. I have the tendency to beat dead horses, especially when it comes to just very strange bits of humor. And I feel like that's exactly what I'm doing right now. By overly, I'm just going to say, I'm going to puckle them so much this episode. It's going to get interesting. And I'm thinking we'll put the mortar in the center of the base. This is a very interesting fort. It's kind of smallish, and there's lots of high trees, so we've got to be very particular where we put our mortar. Here seems to be as good enough as any. We'll put the mortar, and let's get a bunch of infantry, and that should do it. Now, how do I don't really know how to operate the mortar. That's one thing. Heads up, gentlemen. Hopefully one of these guys mans it. That would be ideal. And did I hit anything? I actually did that. So that was kind of cool. This is like the broken church that reminds me of the final battle in that movie with Mel Gibson. What was it called? Patriot. Did you guys ever see The Patriot? It was really cool. The last battle was, I believe, inspired or trying to recreate the Battle of Cowpens, which, by the way, was a tactic used at the Battle of Cannae. It was a very impressive victory in both times that tactic was used. All right, gentlemen, the next wave will be in 9 seconds. Those tea drinkers are coming, and they insist that we be their colonists. But I say, no taxation without representation, especially to people with such poor dental work. All right. Memes and stereotypes aside, hello, British person. You dirty redcoats. What you doing here? You ain't gonna hit nothing. I just love how like the AI will like fight in formation. They'll use firing lines, and it's just awesome. It's downright awesome. And needless to say, our defenses are quite impressive. Do we want a cannon? I'd have to find the perfect spot. And I also am very curious, are my men up here puckling? Sir, are you puckling? If you're not puckling, I would highly encourage you to start puckling. This could be an interesting spot for a cannon. But nobody's over here, which leads me to believe that there's other areas that are more pressing. This one could be an interesting spot for a cannon. Hey, I think right here would be good. All right, gentlemen, please give me covering fire. Ah, oh, there we go. Okay, so I was able to place it. What are you turning around for? Those are our men. Oh my God, if you fire this... Oh, the artificial intelligence is quite artificial and not too intelligent. Hey there, you're playing a flute in a war zone. Have you thought about maybe not doing that? You know what? For what it was worth, that was rather delightful flute playing, okay? You really had me warmed up. All right, so we've got 38 seconds. Man, this would definitely be a good spot for a puckler. And puckled. Okay, yeah, that seems to be decent. I wish you could, like, build other towers and trenches and sandbags and the like. That would be pretty cool. All right, so 3 seconds. Let's see if they come my way, and if they do. Excuse me, who needs a good puckling? Oh, there you go. You all need to get puckled. It fires, like, out of the side, and I'm not entirely sure what that's all about. Is that intentional? Is this a sign? Sorry, Bill, but you were kind of in the way, you see. That looked good. Oh, dude. Or maybe it's the animation. I can't rightfully tell. Are they over here too? They are. Get puckled. And I would imagine that maybe the objective is to defend our... Ooh. If I did not see one of the best spots for a good old puckling... I'm gonna sniper! I missed. Well, not much of a sniper when you miss. Oh, look at the lancers charging in. Huzzah! Oh, well, you're dead. And then I can use my bayonet. We can Stonewall Jackson them and give them the bayonet. I'm gonna build a cannon here. And I'm gonna put it, yeah, like right there. Now, what else can I make? Swivel guns? I think I had a swivel gun. Puckle guns are very big. Yeah, if I put a swivel gun on the side. Yeah, man that cannon. Honestly, this is a pretty good spot for a cannon too. I don't know how the battle lines are drawn. But I feel like guarding the hard points is a good idea. You know what, I'm gonna put a swivel gun here. There we go. That should be adequate. Swivel guns are like those little mini cannons that you'd see oftentimes on pirate ships. This would be a good spot for a swivel gun. They fired a cannon over there. Oh, there they are. I got one. And this guy's puckling them. Yeah, this is definitely the trick, man. Are you hitting them? Yeah, you're hitting them all right. Excellent job. Look at this. It seems to have a mind of its own, but I guess I did put it in an okay spot. Dang, there's 161 redcoats. And they've all got guns. Look at all the smoke and all the absolute chaos going on. Hopefully they don't hit me, you know? There's a drummer. Don't shoot the drummer. Shoot a guy with a gun. There we go. We're definitely wiping the floor on this side. So this is the side that they're making the most headway with. Okay. Maybe I get a cannon up here on the inner wall? Right here. I'm worried about friendly fire. I want to be able to dig trenches. But look at this, man. Revolutionary War Simulator. This is a fortress siege. Ooh, this would be a good spot for maybe a cannon or a swivel gun. So I'm kind of really curious what choke point looks like. But, I mean, we're already at wave 5. I think the goal should be to get, like, maybe wave 10. Whoa, they have 166 men? Oh, they got a new wave in. All right. I may not have gotten the men in time, so this may be a lot more difficult than it otherwise would be because I was distracted. Okay, there's a huge line coming from over there. This is pretty much where most of our defenses are. I need a cannon. What the heck? Dang. Oh, this is bad. Okay, I'm going to get a cannon? No, I'm going to get a swivel gun. We'll put it here. Let's use it. Oh, this thing is like a shotgun. Look at how many redcoats are pouring into the base. Oh my god, this is terrible. Oh, this is bad. We might lose. Wave 7. Dude, they just... Ow. I didn't get the reinforcements in. So they just charged a side we weren't really protecting. They're behind me. Are they stabbing me? Yeah. They're stabbing me, all right. Oh! Okay. This is far less than ideal. Running around with my little flintlock pistol here. Oh man, look at this wall. Okay, I ran too close to it. But their numbers are dropping, so by getting 160 next wave, we should be good. And I think the mortars are doing, let's see, how good are the mortars doing? It'd be cool to see little performance of which weapon systems seem to be doing the best. All right, I'm gonna see if this works. This probably won't. Ha! Oh, I missed. Retreat! Oh no. This guy stepped in quicksand. Hey, don't do that. Jeez. You are not invited to my tea party, sir, because we're not having a tea party. We are down by like 9 men. We gotta hold the line. It's time to puckle them. Are they below the puckling? These men can't even be puckled anymore. All right, boys. We shall give them the bayonet. Yeah! I guess you could do an American Civil War in Napoleonic era. There's a lot of other eras you could do. Don't you... You're not allowed up here. This is VIP pass only. Bet you can't hit me. Oh, God. Ooh, you can't. All right, who reloads faster, me or you? Well... No! The other wave is here. Okay, enough messing around. Who is going to man this cannon? We should have mad reinforcements. We're at 151 men. I think that's my unit cap. But they're not taking their positions. I think a cannon right here would be good. Whoa, the cavalry's here. Where are my men? Oh my god, they're all standing around. This is bad. And there's just too many of them. I need a Ferguson rifle. I need faster reload. Using muskets is just, it's inadequate. And since all my men are not using the defenses anymore, we're getting cut down. This is what you call a really bad situation. So, can I puckle these guys? I should be able to puckle them. Oh yeah! Get puckled! This is the ultimate puckling. Like you can't, you don't want to show this stuff, man. This is some NSF dub puckling right here. But I wonder, can they take our gun emplacements? Oh, that kind of hurt. Am I dead? I'm dead. Okay, weapon select, please. Okay, I do have the saber now. You know what? I think I'm gonna use the saber as my secondary. I'm gonna just go down there and start stabbing. Who wants a saber? Gentlemen, you need to take your positions, man. There we go. Oh no. Oh no. Dun da 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 da. Oh god. Oh god. I got eventually taken down and now we're at 27 men. I mean, is that because there's another new wave or what? I'm gonna try to get as many men as possible, but I think it's not looking good. Not looking good at all. Not looking good at all, gentlemen. Yeah. Oh man, this is bad. Yeah, this is not good. We're down to 4 men. Oh, we made it to what? Wave 8. Okay. I don't want to die at all, but it seems I must. It seems I must. This is bad. What happens now? Do I have to keep dying? I concede. All right, we're gonna spectate, and it is a British victory. Dang, man, now I gotta go drink tea. Balls. So remember that we do have the choke point, and if you guys do want to see more, let me know. Pull the trigger on the like button if you did enjoy the video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.